Let's talk about the additive and multiplicative properties of equalities and inequalities. So let's just look at a number line. Let's say x equals 4 is right there. Let's say I add plus 2 on both sides of the equation. We know that adding a 2 means you're going to move 2 units to the right. So let's add 2 and shift 2 units to the right. And since we added 2 to the x and the 4, both x and 4 that were sitting on this tick mark are now sitting 2 units away, but they're both sitting on the same tick mark again. This is a tick mark where x plus 2 is sitting, and also 4 plus 2 or 6 is sitting. And they're both 2 units away from this tick mark. What do you think will happen if you subtract a 2 from both sides? Do you think we'll still get something similar? So look. If you subtract a 2 from the 4, you'll go 2 units to the left. And you'll also have 2 units to the left for x minus 2. And again, they're both sitting on the same tick mark. What does that tell you? That if you added a 2 to both sides of this equation, you have another equation. Same thing if you subtract a 2 from both sides, you have another equation. These three equations are equivalent to each other. And they were all derived from the equation x equals 4. So in general, then, if you look at x equals 4 and you add a plus c to both sides, it will still remain an equation. So if you have x equals 4 and I add a plus c and c is positive, then I'll be c units to the right of this tick mark. And they'll still be sitting on the same tick mark. So x plus c is equal to 4 plus c. Similarly, if you subtract a c, you'll be moving c units to the left. And again, x minus c would equal 4 minus c. They're sitting on the same tick mark. So think of additive property as follows. If you add or subtract a constant from both sides of the equation, you get another equivalent equation. So let's take a look and see what happens if you have an inequality. So now let's take a look at x less than 4. So on the number line, that means that x sits somewhere to the left of 4. So let's say it sits here. Let's add 2 to both x and 4 and see what happens to the tick marks. We already saw from before that adding a 2 to x means it will move 2 units to the right. Adding a 2 to the 4 means it will move 2 units to the right. So if I add 5, then it's going to go 5 units to the right. But look at where x plus 5 is relative to 4 plus 5. When you add a 5, the relative positions of x plus 5 is still to the left of 4 plus 5. Can you see that? So that means that if you add a number on both sides of an inequality, it preserves the inequality. Preserve means if x is to the left of 4, then x plus 5 is to the left of 4 plus 5. Similarly, if you subtract, same thing happens, and x minus 5 is to the left of 4 minus 5. So again, the inequality is preserved. So it looks like we could add or subtract a number on both sides of the inequality as long as it's the same number. Added or subtracted from both sides of the inequality is preserved, just like the equation was preserved. So in general, if I were to add c units, c is positive, I'll have x plus c is to the left of 4 plus c, and x minus c is to the left of 4 minus c. So again, the inequality is preserved if you add or subtract the same constant from both sides of the inequality. Same thing will happen if you have equations. So both for equations and inequalities, you can add or subtract the same number from both sides and preserve it. So let's write that down formally then. You can add or subtract the same number on both sides of an inequality or an equation and preserve it. So that means if I start with A equaling B, then A plus C equals B plus C, and also A minus C equals B minus C. Similarly, if you have A less than B, then A plus C smaller than B plus C, A minus C smaller than B minus C, and so on. Remember what this symbol means, greater equals. All of the inequalities are preserved as long as what? You add number on both sides the same number or subtract the same number. So if it's an equation, it will remain equation. If it's an inequality, it will remain an inequality of the same type. So let's see how that's going to help us in removing items away from the variable. Let's start with this. Remember what our goal was. Our eventual goal is to solve for x. But right now, let's just see how can we isolate the x. So in order to isolate 2x, what should we do? This is an equation, and we have a plus 3. What can undo addition? Subtraction undoes addition. So if you subtract 3 from both sides, remember, it still preserves the equality. So this equation that you see here, 2x plus 3 minus 3 equaling 8 minus 3. This, the solutions of this equation are going to be equivalent to solutions of this equation. So what we get here, 2x equals 5 because 8 minus 3 is 5. All right, let's do the same thing with inequalities. Again, I am allowed to subtract 3 from both sides, preserving the inequality, or you'll get 2x is smaller than 5. So what we're essentially doing is, in order to find solutions of this equation, it is enough to find solutions of this equation. In order to find solutions of this inequality, it is enough to find solutions of this inequality. So we are transforming the equations and inequalities into equivalent equations and inequalities so that we can solve the simpler ones to get the solution of the original one. So now what we can do? Instead of plus 3, it's a minus 3. So to undo minus 3, we can add a 3 on both sides, and then look what happens. So now we'll have 2x equals 11. You can do the same here. So it doesn't really matter what the left-hand side, right-hand side looks like. As long as you add or subtract the same number on both sides, the inequality is preserved or the equality is preserved. And then you have a simpler inequality or equation to work with. All right, let's try this one on your own. Remember, our goal is to have all the variable terms on the same side. So what do you think we should do? Go ahead, pause the video and try it on your own. Good. So we have 2x equals 6 plus 5x. So we're going to see if we can get rid of the 5x. Adding 5x can be gotten rid of by subtracting 5x. So let's subtract 5x on both sides. You see, this is what you did in module 2 now. If you know how to add or subtract, you're good. 2x minus 5x is what? Come on, give me an answer. Good. Negative 3x. So this will become negative 3x equals 6. Do the same. You can do the same thing here. As long as you do it on both sides, the inequality is preserved. So you're going to get negative 3x is smaller than 6. All right, let's try this one on your own. How are you going to undo subtraction of 5x? You have to? Good, add 5x. And what would be 2x plus 5x? That would be 7x equals 6. And you can do the same here. This is very, very important. Look, it doesn't matter what kind of equation or inequality you have. If you add or subtract same number from both sides, you are preserving the equality or the inequality. So I'm subtracting 3 here, and here's what you got. You can do the same if it was an inequality. Subtract, and there's what you got. Okay, try this one on your own. Remember what this symbol means? It means absolute value. You would read that as 2 times absolute value x minus 3 equals 7. All right. Okay, try this one now. Same thing. Add 3 on both sides. You can see there is no difference between equation and inequalities. Whatever you can do with equations, with adding and subtracting, you can do the same with inequalities, and it's preserved. Go ahead, try it on your own. Good, subtract 5 from both sides. Do the same here.